Since our last video, I've finished developing my one-line diagram. I added the remaining breakers, tied them to the bus, and cleaned things up a bit. All that's left to do is save my page. However, Graphics Editor has caught an error in my page configuration and indicates this in the Binding Issues counter at the top of the page. Clicking this link opens the Connection Debugger. On the left side of the page, I have a navigation bar to select the different component types and the pages they are on. I can choose to sort them either by component, then page, or swap that with the selector at the top of the screen. I see here that there's an error with a breaker, so I'll select that node. The state column quickly identifies the breaker with the issue, and if I hover over the X icon, the tooltip tells me that every property must have a value. Scrolling across, I see that while my top bus name for this breaker is filled out, the bottom is not. The bottom bus for this breaker will feed into another page, so I'll give it a unique name based on the breaker. While I'm here, observe that I can set the parameters for any of my one-line components in the debugger. In fact, you may find that it's easier to configure the source's active condition or custom breaker states here rather than in the graphics themselves. Whatever changes I make here are automatically written back into the page. At this point, I've corrected all the errors in the debugger. I could click the button Create Configuration File, but it's not necessary. The file is created automatically when I save my page or close the debugger. If I navigate to my TGML folder, what this does is update the one-line configuration .json file. The debugger takes all the information from our pages and writes it to this file, which is what the one-line engine reads. While we don't generally touch this file, there may be manual configuration necessary at some point. Now that I've saved my changes, my one-line diagram functions as expected. In the next video, we'll look at the other function of the debugger, changing the color scheme. Until then, thank you.